Welcome everyone to tonight's virtual Purple Light. We are honored to be tonight's presenting sponsor. My name is Dr. Matthew Schwartz, and I'm a radiation oncologist and marketing chair here at Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada. Purple Light brings communities together to honor survivors, provide inspiration to those who are fighting pancreatic cancer, and remember those we've lost. We proudly stand with the Pancreatic Cancer Action Network as leaders in the fight against pancreatic cancer, as we work to accelerate progress for patients today and those diagnosed in the future. Progress is being made. The five-year survival rate is improving, but this is certainly not good enough. We will keep fighting, and we will not waver in our resolve to rewrite the story of pancreatic cancer. I would like to now introduce you to your Purple Light Chair, Karen Wall.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Thank you to Dr. Matthew Schwartz and Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada. We are honored to have you as our presenting sponsor this evening. I'd also like to take a moment to thank Renee Egan-Williams for all of her work to put this together. Truthfully, she does like 90% of this, and I do a very little bit. Tonight, we have come together to fight pancreatic cancer for patients, for survival, for progress. Please remember to not crack your glow stick until the name of your loved one is read later on in the ceremony. It is my pleasure to introduce 12-year-old youth advocate Lola Shanahan. Lola advocates on behalf of her grandfather.
Hello, my name is Lola Shanahan, and I'm a youth advocate for pancreatic cancer research. Why? Because I lost my grandpa, William MacArthur, to the disease when I was just 3 years old. My mom shares stories of how we were so close and how I was the light of his eye. Sadly, as the years passed by, so do my vivid memories of him. But through my advocacy and through your advocacy, the spirits of our loved ones will continue to live on. Tonight, we light our luminaries in their memory and to honor those that are currently fighting this disease. Scientists are learning more each day, so we must continue to raise our voices and share our stories. I speak on behalf of all youth. Please continue setting good examples for us, and we will follow, and when you grow tired, we will lead.
Thank you, Lola. That was truly inspiring. As Lola mentioned, the way we rewrite the story is by advancing research, building and sustaining federal support, providing resources for patients, families, and caregivers, and raising greater awareness of the world's toughest cancer. Each of you plays an important role in helping us accelerate progress for patients by volunteering, donating, and raising awareness in the community as we are doing here tonight. You are making a difference. When this community comes together, we form a commitment to remember those we have lost, honor those who are with us, and inspire courage. We hope that we can all make a real difference. Together, we will improve outcomes for pancreatic cancer patients. We are all here for a reason. Many of us are here to honor and remember loved ones and friends, a special someone. For each of us, it started with someone. We all have stories about that someone. We carry these stories with us wherever we go. They are part of us. If we are going to beat this disease, we need more people to join the fight. I invite you to learn more about our work and how your talents and time can make an impact. I want to remind everyone that if you know someone affected by pancreatic cancer, encourage them to contact the Pancreatic Cancer Action Network's Patient Services for free resources and support. Now we will hear from Marianne Fusco, a 14-year survivor and volunteer.
Hi, my name is Marianne Fusco, and I am a pancreatic cancer survivor. My journey began 14 years ago, and all I can say, it's been a rough and frightening experience. Because you see, we haven't heard of anybody else having this cancer other than Patrick Swayze. Well, through our journey, we've had many highs and lows, sleepless nights, always worried about test results from scans and labs. Lots of prayers, numerous setbacks along the way. I had a Whipple, and I went through chemo, plus many years of immunotherapy infusions, and you're feeling like you're the only one going through this nightmare. Your entire world has changed forever. Well, all that changed 4 years ago. We saw something about a pancreatic cancer walk fundraiser, so we signed up for it. We were very curious. We didn't know what to expect. Well, much to our amazement, we couldn't believe the amount of people that were at this event. We just figured that maybe a few would show up because realistically, you don't hear much about this cancer at all. Well, I met lots of survivors like myself. I couldn't get over how many lives have been affected by this disease. It was such an amazing experience to be surrounded in a sea of purple. Since then, I've been involved with PanCAM, and through the fundraising and research being done, our 5-year survival rate went from 5 to 10%. My goal is to help them reach 100% through early detection. This is my mission. PanCAM provides you with all the necessary tools needed for survivors and caregivers. Take it from me, nobody should feel that they're alone through this battle. I joined PanCAM because it's my way of giving back. I want to give people hope and let them know that there is life after a pancreatic cancer diagnosis. I am now the Nevada Affiliate Survivor Caregiver Co-Chair. Thank you.
Thank you, Marianne. We are so grateful to have you as our Survivor Caregiver Co-Chair and as a survivor in our community. We have pancreatic cancer survivors from all over the country with us tonight. We recognize survivors as anyone who has fought or is currently fighting pancreatic cancer. Survivors are a symbol of hope for all of us in the pancreatic cancer community. To all survivors with us tonight, we honor you. You motivate us in the fight against pancreatic cancer, and we support you and commend you for your strength and spirit. Now I would like to welcome our mission chair, Nikki Campagna, to read What Cancer Cannot Do.
Carl and Bonnie Brunson were originally going to be reading this poem, but were unable to do so. I am reading this for the two of you with fond thoughts and prayers for strength and healing. What cancer cannot do. Cancer is so limited. It cannot cripple love. It cannot shatter hope. It cannot corrode faith. It cannot destroy peace. It cannot kill friendship. It cannot suppress memories. It cannot silence courage. It cannot invade the soul. It cannot steal eternal life. And it cannot conquer the spirit.
This isn't necessarily for the people that are fighting the disease, but also their support system.
Of course.
Oh my God.
You can't do it alone. Like,
no.
You just can't.
Breathe in. Don't look down. It's a long road full of doubt. But right here and right now, I'll be your solid ground. And we'll fight harder.
Oh,
moves alive. So when you feel
thank you, Nikki, for giving us hope and strength as we continue to fight this battle. Good evening. My name is Jess Ludke, and I am the Nevada Affiliate Gratitude Chair. Tonight, we remember those who have bravely fought this disease and are not here with us tonight. The five-year survival rate is 10%, which is unacceptable. It is estimated that this year alone, 57,600 people will receive a pancreatic cancer diagnosis, and 47,050 people will lose their battle with this disease. Let us take time to honor those who have lost their battle against pancreatic cancer with a 47-second moment of silence. Now we will begin our Purple Light name reading ceremony to recognize all the loved ones we are honoring and remembering this evening, including all of our survivors who are currently fighting or who have won their fight. These individuals, along with so many others, are the reasons why we continue to push for progress and why we demand better each day. I apologize in advance if we mispronounce anyone's name. Fred Elberts, Mark Anton, Luis Arvizu, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Alicia Beach, Harold Bellinger, Louis Brito, Patrick Brown, Sandy Brown, Carl Brunson, Alicia Caballas, Vinny Colligero, Al Caminata, Greg Caravella, Gina Churchill, Tony Cavelli, Doug Cox, Anita Davis, Victor Dean, Nancy Doherty, Wanda Elam, Linda Elder, Jim Fetty, Maria Flint, Christy Ford, Marianne Fusco. Darla Gliptis. Frankie Greger. B. Greg. Salvatore Gruino. Wayne Harris. Helen Hayes Thomas. John Heineman. Sally Hoffman. Danny Jackson. Michelle Jim. Denny Joy. Nancy Juvie. Dale Keller. Bruce Clafter. Scott Klein. Mike Knuckles. Mary LaFranz. Bill Lambries. Mabel Linthicum. Jeff Lowndes. Mary Ellen Lowndes. Elaine Lozano. Ginny Ludke. Jonathan Ludke. Burnett Maloney King. Ed Malinowski. William MacArthur. Frank Messina. Mary Mitchell Glass. Radis Merle. Jerry Nelms. Cedric Nelson. Rachel Nutzling. Garfield Ogilvy. Carol Paglino. Reggie Palmer. Jim Petrakos. Sandra Pettingill. Victor Placencia. Linda Platt. Kevin Poligratis. Nicholas Rago. Carmen Michelle Reyes. Anthony Richardson. Carolyn Rodrigues. Charlotte Ruskowitz. Grace Schaller. Nancy Shine. Devette Shea. Stephen Allen Singleton. Virginia Soares. Lori Strong. Dorothy Strook. G. Ty. Myra Townsend. Donald Turi. Mackie Tyndall. Robert Michael Valoria. Bill Vaughn. Vicky Walker. Evie Wallin. Adeline Weglars. David Watley. Susan Winken. Rui Ziegler.
Margaret Barnum. Marilyn Baker.
A lot of us are wearing purple tonight. This color represents the passion, commitment, and unrelenting spirit in the fight against pancreatic cancer. It represents the strength of our community, and most importantly, it represents hope. I encourage everyone to carry this hope with you and continue to fight this deadly disease. And please wear purple on Thursday, November 19th for World Pancreatic Cancer Day.
As we close our ceremony, I hope that your passion for this cause will continue to burn bright long after tonight. And I encourage each of you to rise up and join us as we fight pancreatic cancer. Our fight continues all year long, long after tonight. We host Purple Light in the fall to honor and remember our loved ones, and we host Purple Stride in the spring to raise the critical funds needed for further research, for patients, for survivors, for progress. I encourage each of you to join us on Saturday, March 20th for our 7th annual Purple Stride. We will be posting a separate slideshow following the ceremony that will include the pictures and stories that were submitted by many of you. I would now like to introduce Caitlin Shea, who will sing Rise Up to close our ceremony this evening. Thank you again for joining us, and stay safe and healthy.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Shea. I am a caregiver for my mom, Davette Shea, who has been battling pancreatic cancer since January. And this song is for her and every brave patient fighting this fight.
You're broken down and tired, living life on the merry-go-round. And you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains, we gon' walk it out. Move mountains, and I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up, rise like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, for you. When the silence isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Move mountains, bring it to its feet. Move mountains, and I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, I'll rise for you. For that we have each other, and for that we have each other. We will rise, we will rise, we will rise. Oh, we'll rise. I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I will rise a thousand times again, and we'll rise up high like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, will rise. again.